Let's try that.
Click new email.
Press F6. Press left. Click send receive. Click folder. Press Alt F. Press Alt H.
Say click send. Press Shift F10. Automatically sort emails.
Click help.
Hi everyone, welcome back to the MyRSILife.com YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to show you some of the best practices and ways that I use Outlook email with Dragon Dictation. We're going to be able to send new emails, reply to emails, surf through the Outlook menus and change our settings. We're going to be able to organize our emails into folders and write rules for Outlook to automatically categorize those emails. So let's get into it. Let's start first by using Dragon to command opening Outlook. Wake up. Open Outlook. Go to sleep.
Now let's show you how to navigate around the different areas of Outlook. And I'll also, as I'm surfing, describe what the section is called. So right now what's selected is an email in the inbox. So let's just surf around. Wake up, press down. Press down, press down, press page down, press page down, go to the top, go to the bottom, go to the top, go to sleep. Within the inbox, you can see when it's selected, you can use the scroll commands like page down, page up, up, down, go to the top, go to the bottom. Very handy. I'll show you a few more here. Wake up, press F6, go to sleep. So press F6 moves the selection around Outlook, kind of like in a circle. It's kind of weird, but you can see when I said that, the selector went from the inbox to the reading pane. What's highlighted in blue around here is called the reading pane. Let's continue pressing F6 and see what happens. Wake up. Press F6, press F6, press F6, press down, press enter, go to sleep. So hopefully you can follow what was going on there. It moved down to the display settings, then moved up to the what's called the ribbon. And then pressed F6 again, or commanded it anyway, and it moved to the navigation bar. That's what this is called here on the left. Sometimes it's on the bottom, depending on how your settings are. And we selected the calendar by pressing down, pressing enter.
Another navigation tip is Control-1 and Control-2. That's another way you can swap between the calendar and the inbox. Let's try that out. Wake up. Press Control-2. Press Control-3. Press Control-1. Go to sleep. Pretty cool.
So let's keep going here. Wake up. Go to the inbox. Press Shift F6. Press up. Go to the top. Press left. Press right, press left, press right, go to sleep. So this isn't used that much, but you can see I'm collapsing and expanding the inbox there. So I can expand my files, collapse my files, whatever. Wake up, press down, press enter, press Shift F6, press down, press left. Press down, press down, press enter, go to sleep. So now you saw there, I just opened and closed those folders. I went to my sent mail. We're just kind of navigating around. And there's a lot of settings that you can see up in the ribbon. So let's see how we can access that. Wake up. Click send receive. Click home. Click folder. Click view. Click help. Click home. Go to sleep. So those all work very well and very easily. Now, click file doesn't exactly work. I will show you that one. Wake up. Click file. Go to sleep. It opened the dictation box. I'm not sure exactly why it did that. Click file doesn't work. So we have another one. It's press Alt F. So let's try that. Wake up. Click cancel. Press Alt F. Go to sleep. There we have the file menu. Press Alt F. Wake up. Press down. Press down. Press down. Press down. Press tab. Press down. Press down. Go to sleep. Just like you saw in the first tutorial video, the navigation keys like press tab, press shift tab goes left to right or selects one menu after another. Press down, press up, all of those, remember to use those. They can be very handy. Wake up, press escape, press escape. Press Alt H, press M, press V. Press O. Click cancel. Click send receive. Press Alt H. Press escape. Press O. Press A. Press alpha. Click cancel. Go to sleep. So that's a pretty powerful one if you want to change some settings with your voice. So that's it for navigation. So try some things on your own, try those shortcuts. Now let's get into writing an email. So we can use the command, click new email. Wake up, click new email. Click cancel. List all windows. Choose three. Click new email. Go to sleep. So there you see, you should have Outlook selected before you say click new email. It won't know what to do. I had another application selected there. Okay, so now we're ready to write an email. Wake up. M. Press down. Press enter. Go to sleep. So when you have a history of emailing folks, I mean, this is standard Outlook application, but Outlook remembers who you've emailed in the past and will save their first and last name if they have a Microsoft profile associated with that email address. And so I've emailed this person before. You can see it's another one of my email accounts. So play around with that too. Of course, you could use the spell functionality if it's a new email address and things like that. Wake up, press tab, press M, press down, press down, press down, press enter, press tab. Click BCC. Go to subject. Test email 123. Capitalize that. Press tab. Hi there, comma, new line. New line. Little Red Riding Hood is on her way with a basket of treats, period. Capitalize Red Riding. New line, new line, thanks comma, new line, Mitch. Go to sleep. Now you can say click send to send the email. It's that easy.
So that is how to send an email. We've kind of reviewed how to surf the inbox on how to read emails. Let's talk about how to organize emails. There's a lot of really handy tips and ways you can automate your email by using your voice and just setting these up, and then Outlook will kind of run itself. So let's get into that. I'm gonna show you one of my very favorite commands, and it is to open the right-click menu. It's Shift F10. Press Shift F10. Click Move. Click Other Folder. Go to the top. Press up, press up, press up, press up, press right, press down, press down, press right, click New, Test Folder. Click OK. Click OK. Go to sleep. So there we were able to open the right-click menu, select that we wanted to move the email, and then we even created a new folder to put that email into. Let's just create a folder by itself without having to select an email first. Wake up, press Shift F10. Click New Folder. Test Folder 2. Select 2. Choose 1. Press Enter. Go to sleep. Easy as that. Use that right-click menu. Okay, now let's move some emails into that folder. Wake up. Press F6. Press Shift F10, click Move, press Enter. There we go. Click Cancel. Go to sleep. So I'll introduce you to some powerful functionality that will automatically sort emails in your inbox according to rules that you set up. I've used this a lot in my work life. If you are managing an inbox or working with a team of people to manage an inbox, this can be pretty helpful. So I'll show you how to set up a new rule for a given email. Wake up, press Shift F10, click Rules, click Create Rule. Go to sleep. Okay, so here's the menu where we can create a rule. We can do it based on the subject. Sometimes it says announcement from HR, and anything that says those exact words, announcement from HR, will go into whatever folder that you create it for. Or you can have a sent to, you can use all the settings that you see here. Wake up, press Tab, press Enter, click Subject Contains, press Tab, press Tab, press Tab, click Move the item to folder, click Test Folder 2, click OK, click OK. Click Run this rule now on messages already in the current folder. Click OK. Press down. Go to sleep. So what it did there is it made the rule and then looked through the entire inbox to look for any message that met that rule, and it put it in the test folder there. You can see that there's 30 red unread messages in there. And we can go open that folder and go look at those. Next, I will show you how to open an attachment in Outlook. So let's check it out. Wake up, press up, press enter, go to sleep. So that opens the email if you've selected the email in the inbox pane and press enter, it will open it up like this. Wake up, press tab, press tab, press tab, press tab, press tab, press tab, press enter, press enter. Go to sleep. So opening that attachment wasn't exactly easy. If any of you in the comments knows a better way to open the attachments or, you know, surf the attachments menus, go ahead and let me know. In conclusion, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. If you have other ideas for things you want to see on the channel, or if you have other Outlook tips that I may have missed, go ahead and leave those in the comments below. See you next time.